Okay, so our next speaker is Chantal Capelletti, giving a presentation on overview on launch picosat deployment systems and future launch opportunities.
Let's switch on. Okay, can you hear me? Okay, I'm Chantal, I'm from Gauss SRL. I am one of the two owners of the company. Gauss SRL is an Italian company founded in Rome in 2012. Our history comes out from the School of Aerospace Engineering in the University of Rome La Sapienza. We were a small laboratory inside the University of La Sapienza. Our group of astrodynamics for the use of space, group of astrodynamics of the University of Rome Sapienza worked from early 90 up to 2012, designed several satellites. In 20 years, we launched up to six different satellites as a university program. The idea was to launch a satellite each 2 years. In 2012, some changement in the university occurred, and so the School of Aerospace Engineering was stopped for a while, and our group was looking what to do with our history, with our background. So the idea was to build, to set up a new company. And in 2012, we decided to start the new adventure as a small company with Gauss. So Gauss is an Italian limited liability company, and the acronym Gauss means a group of astrodynamics for the use of space system. From 2012 up to now, we launched several satellites. I will give you a brief overview of what we did in the last years. So this is the satellite we launched as a university team. UNISAT 1 was launched in 2000. After 2 years, we launched UNISAT 2. In 2004, we launched UNISAT 3. After UNISAT 4, and after we had the FIST grant from the Italian Space Agency. All the first satellites were managed, were designed, built, financed using money coming from the, so really small grant. In 2009, we get the first grant from the Italian Space Agency. We were able to design the EDUSAT satellite. And in the meantime, we start also the design of one of the two first CubeSat in Italy. It was in CubeSat GG, launched by Vega in 2012. In few steps, this is our history. From 2000 to 2012, six satellites launched as a university team. In 2012, we established our company. In 2013, we launched the first UNISAT as a company, UNISAT 5. In 2014, we launched the UNISAT 6. In 2015, we started a cooperation with the Japanese company GEMS to launch a satellite also using the International Space Station. And we launched two satellites using, really three satellites using the International Space Station. In 2016, we launched our new R3U CubeSat, able to deploy in orbit tubes using the International Space Station. Our activity and products are mainly dedicated to small satellite. Launch service, but also design manufacturing of launch satellite, offering service for ground operation. We have also, since we started our space debris research when we were at university, we decided to continue our activity on space debris detection and using our own observatory. We have now two observatories in Italy completely dedicated to the observation of space debris, and also we perform mission nights for external customers. These are our main products for our satellite. We serve for structure, we have our own onboard computer. We offer also an electric power system. We have a different kind of radio communication system. Of course, we also support the different team all over the world to install their own ground station, also offering our own service. But mainly today, I would like to talk about our activity as a launch provider. The company is can be considered one of the main launch brokers for CubeSat, and we are able to offer service for really thin satellite, few grams, up to 40, 50 kilo, using different platform. At the moment, we are the only company in the world, in the space industry, is able to provide our launch service in LEO orbit for any kind of micro, pico, femto satellite. In particular, we launched the Linsat, CubeSat, Pocket Cubes, and we were the only one to be able also. We were the only one to launch the Pocket Cube and also the CubeSat. Our launch service are mainly offer launch using the International Space Station, in particular the Kibo module operated by JAMS. JAMS is a Japanese company, Japan Managed Space System Corporation, that used to work closely with JAXA. And we also use several launch vehicle. In particular, we had a very good partnership up last year to the Dnieper. Unfortunately, the project was canceled last year, and now we are working with. Okay, perfect. Okay, now we are working with other launch. Sorry, just 1 second. Sorry. So we are using different launch vehicle. Okay. In particular, our idea is to board inside the launch vehicle, not just the deployer attached to the fairing, but also to use our own platform that is called Unisat. We are a very traditional, so we don't like to change names. So we are using since early 90s the same name. So we are like Russian that use Cosmos for all the objects they launch. In any case, what's new in our idea? Our idea is to have a satellite as a launch platform. Why to use this kind of solution? Because there are so many advantages in using a launch platform. In particular, the payload are no longer tied to the scheduled mission of the launch vehicle, so you can be more flexible. We have our platform was scheduled to be launched, for example, now at the end of 2019. So if the customer are ready, they can be boarded. If they are not ready, they can be substituted by other customer flexible. In particular, one of the main advantages is that when you launch the satellite, normally, also in the last mission, you are one of 100 satellites. So it will be very difficult to find your satellite in the middle of the clouds of satellite launched from the same rocket. So in this case, when you are launched using a launch as a launch platform as a Unisat, you will be not launched directly in the middle of the clouds, but we will wait some times to be released. In particular, in the last mission, we wait 1 day before to release our daughter satellite. It's possible to release the payloads when you want. So you can schedule exactly in which position you want to launch the, what time you want to release your satellite in the orbit. So it's easier to follow your own satellite, your small satellite, using the TLE of UNISAT. You have the main platform. You can that is really easy to be detected by NORAD. And you can use that TLE to understand where exactly is your satellite. It can be useful for that. And also, this kind of solution is really interesting for the design of constellation, because you can release the satellite in different time. And also, the idea is to equip the platform in the near future with active attitude and orbital determination control system in order to move the platform in different orbital position and to release the satellite in different orbits. This kind of platform is used not just to release satellite, but also to test and orbit different payload. For example, we tested several payloads during UNISAT 5 and UNISAT 6 missions. Some of them were the orbiting device system, other solar panel, COTS camera, also our own products. And also the platform is normally equipped with few devices. Like for example, we have a camera that will take an image of the satellite during the release instant. So this is an image, for example, of Tigrisat that was one of the two CubeSat we launched during UNISAT 6 mission. We just board inside the satellite a very low-cost camera, and we decide to take picture during the release of the satellite. And so we are going to implement this this opportunity also for the next mission. After we complete the release of all our satellite, we start to play with our own satellite. Really, we make fun with that. For example, we use the camera just to take some image of the Earth. And if you go in our website, you can download a lot of image, also video, looking what we see with our UNISAT 6 mission. During the last 2 years, during the two missions, UNISAT 5 and UNISAT 6, we were able to launch in space 12 of small satellites. Some of them were CubeSat, some of them were cubes, Pocket Cube. Today, since we are in the Pocket Cube workshop, we will just focus our attention on the Pocket CubeSat launched. In the the only mission of Pocket Cube up to now, that were UNISAT 5, we launched five Pocket Cube using a deployer mechanism called Mr. FOD, that means MORED ROM Femto Orbital Deployer. Was the result of a joint cooperation between Gauss and MORED State University with the supervision of Professor Twix. The idea was to have a deployer attached inside the UNISAT 5. The deployer, designed by a student at MORED State University, were able to launch 1P, 2P, and 2.5P. We tested the deployer first on the 2012 mission on EDUSAT. At the time, it was not possible to release Pocket Cube since there were a constraint from the launch vehicle, and at the end, we were not able to launch any Pocket Cube, but we were able just to test our deployer. In 2015, we launched with the UNISAT 5, sorry, 2012, and now we are working to implement the deployer for UNISAT 7 mission. In the first mission, we launched several Pocket Cube. For example, we launched T-Logo Cube and a $50 satellite. There were two Pocket Cube launched by MORED State University and several different partners. The first one was 2.5P and the other was 1.5P. The goal of this Pocket Cube were just a technological demonstrator and educational, and they have the educational purposes involving students from undergraduate student in the design of small satellite. The other one that really is the one that I like more, and also here there are Paul and Sasha, is the Vrena satellite. It was the smallest one launched, and was a 1P pocket cube. I think they maybe already talked about that. It was a 5 by 5 by 5 centimeter pocket cube with 250 grams. And the other one was Kubi Scout from the University of Maryland. It was 2.5P pocket cube, also with educational goal, technological demonstrator objective. To be honest, there were another pocket cube inside the same mission, that was the Puk Pocket SAT, really difficult to pronounce it. There was a pocket cube that was inside Puk Pusat, that was a CubeSat, one of the cubes that we released on UNISAT 5 mission. So UNISAT 5 mission were able to launch Puk Pusat, one UP, and the one new CubeSat. And after the one new CubeSat released, we really don't have any data about that, another 1P pocket cube. Now we are working on the design of a new deployer, taking advantage of our experience on UNISAT 5, also to modify the capability of the deployer. So the G-Pocket deployer is a deployer for Pocket Cube that has the capability to launch from 0.5P up to 4P in order to be compatible with the dimension of UNISAT 7. And there is a new version of Mr. FOD. Really, there are two opportunities on the G-Pocket, and I will show you later. We are also working together with JAMS to design a version of UNISAT 7 to release Pocket Cube from the International Space Station. In that case, there are several issues related to the space debris, also the assurance for the International Space Station. So we are trying to find a solution to make possible the launch of Pocket Cube in the near future using also their Hippo platform. The idea on this deployer is to use new kind of material, also lighter and more easily customizable. In particular, we will take advantage of our last satellite. This is the two-pod. The two-pod is three U-cubes completely designed using additive manufacturing technique, and also using a new kind of material that was designed for automotive industry in Italy, in the area of Modena, so really where there is Ducati and Ferrari. So this material was designed to test some part of Ducati, and we tested the material also for space for the use in space. In particular, several missions carried different components made by using this technique and also this material. The two-pod was the only one, the only one that was completely designed using this material that's called WinForm. We tested the satellite we qualified the satellite to be launched from the International Space Station, and also we launched that in 2016 using the Kibo module. The idea of two-pod was to release in orbit the first two CubeSat ever. One CubeSat from an elementary school in Brazil that is called Ubatuba. The school is called Tancredi, is from Ubatuba in Brazil. And the other one is from a private company in US. These are some images of the release from the International Space Station. And taking advantage of this mission, we are thinking to redesign part of our deployer using additive manufacturing. In particular, the new deployer for Pocket will be completely done using additive manufacturing, but also some other deployer for example, our deployer for CubeSat, for 6U CubeSat, will be done using additive manufacturing. I want to give you a brief overview about next mission. Next mission will be UNISAT 7. Unisat 7 will be a satellite of up to 40 kilo with several deployer mechanisms inside. In particular, we will have four deployer for PocketCube, four deployer for CubeSat, and we will also board a different optical payload, for example, a wide angle camera, also narrow angle camera. We will also increase our telecommunication capability, boarding ice band system, and also new radio we design in UHF. We already signed the contract with Soyuz, and the launch is scheduled for the end of 2019. We are offering several launch opportunities. In particular, the price we are offering for CubeSat is for 1U 80K, for 2U 130, for 3U or 2U plus 190. The orbit will be a synchronous orbit of 500, between 500 and 600 kilometers, really will be around the 550. And LTIN from the launch will be 11 AM. About PocketCube, we are changing our approach to the launch service for PocketCube. So we are not anymore signing contract directly with only one customer, but we are selling the complete deployer. So we have a 4P deployer, mm-hmm. and the 4P deployer will be sold for 65K euro. The idea is that different customers will join in a consortium and will be we'll have only one leader that will sign only one single launch service agreement with us. And in this way, we can maintain the price of 65K euro. Otherwise, for us, it's too complicated to have several customers and to fill one deployer and several controls, several people to talk. And it will be a waste of time for us and a waste of money. So in this way, just one representative of the consortium will be the one that will sign the contract. In this way, with 65K, will be possible to buy a complete 4P deployer. About the standard we are using, in Unisat 7, we'll be able to use different standard for Pocket, because we know, everybody here know, there is no any standard already for PocketCube. We are working closely with the University of Delft. Alba Orbital to come out with a common document to define the standard. But in any case, in Unisat 7, we will be able to board the old version of PocketCube, so that compatible with the Unisat 5 mission, so the same dimension we used for Unisat 5 mission. Why this choice? Because we have some customers that already booked the launch since years, and so they were waiting for the launch, and maybe they already finished the design of the platform, so they don't have any more money to modify the structure of the platform. So we will continue to offer them the same condition. In the same times, we are designing the so. We are adapting the new deployer for the standard that we are defining with Alba Orbital and University of Delft. And also, since we are using additive manufacturing, we are pretty flexible. So if the customer requests a modification on the deployer, it's really easy to modify the deployer and to adapt to the needs of the customer. Of course, when the customer will ask some modification, we will suggest something related to our experience, so related to the experience we gained during the Unisat 5 mission. So what we can offer is, of course, the launch service, but also the realization of constellation of small satellite using this platform. We can offer, of course, also the manufacturing rapid deployment and space of cluster of small satellite, and also provide other service like territory monitoring, data collection over large areas, or critical network monitoring or security. So, in conclusion, this is what we gained during the last few years. So our experiences has been proven with different missions. So we are ready to fly the next one. So if you are interested to fly with us in the next UNISAT mission, these are our contacts. So please feel free to contact us, and we will look to find you the best solution. I would like to take advantage of this presentation also to invite all of you in a very nice and warm place in Ubatuba. So we are organizing the 3rd International Academy of Astronautics Latin American CubeSat workshop that will be in Ubatuba, very nice place. It's also the place where the children were able to design and launch their own satellite. So it's completely different from here. Very warm, will be between 25 and 50 degrees, will be exactly summer, so the nice spot in the nice time. And so there will be also a section dedicated to PocketCube, and so you are very welcome to participate. Thank you very much.
Am I right to think it's strange that somebody from Google is talking about CubeSat deployers and doesn't mention Vega at all, the Vega launcher? I mean, they've got a special deployer that's now moved from 18 to 19 because of an Italian satellite that didn't want co-passengers. You know the story, but basically, is Vega on your radar, or for some reason or another, is Vega not on your radar?
Vega is always on our radar. The problem is that Italians are very crazy people. It's very difficult to cooperate in Italy. We were in contact with the guys that were working for the deployer, but since years we didn't hear anything back from them. We will love to work with Vega. Also, some of my colleagues and friends from university are in Avio right now, so they are working for Vega. But to get a launch service agreement with them, it's really, really difficult. And also, to be honest, it's more expensive than using other launch vehicles. So we are looking for that. It looks like in the near future that something will change, also with the modification inside the Italian Space Agency, also inside the Avio. Maybe in the near future we will also be able to offer a launch opportunity from Vega. For now, we don't have any things right signed. Okay, thank you.
Thank you very much.